Hello everyone, my name is Mini Sethi. I hope you all are staying healthy. Today we are going to talk about the meaning of research design, features of good research design, and types of research design, in which we will talk about exploratory research design, descriptive research design, and causal research design. So let's start it. So what is research design? Research design is a master plan. Research design is a master plan that specifies methods and procedures for collecting and analyzing needed information. Research design is a master plan that specifies methods and procedures for collecting and analyzing needed information. As we know, research is all about collecting information, or we can say that research is all about collecting data. When we make plan or prepare blueprint, what methods, procedures, techniques and strategies we will use for collecting information, it will be called research design. Now we will see features of good research design. First is reliability. Your research design should be reliable. Your research design should be reliable. It should not consist any unreliable information. Next is objectivity. Your research design should be accurate and objective. That means your research design should be based on facts, not on your personal feeling. Next is validity. Your research design should be valid. That means research design should not consist any irrelevant information. It only consists information that you need for your research. Next is minimize wastage of time and confusion. Obviously, good research design minimize wastage of time and confusion. Last is flexibility. Your research design should be flexible. That means your research design should change according to situation. It should not be rigid. Now we will see types of research design. First type is exploratory research design. We conduct exploratory research design when researcher has few information related to his problem. We conduct exploratory research when researcher has few information related to his problem. His problem is not clearly defined. He doesn't have any past data related to his problem. And exploratory research gives better understanding of existing problem. And we can explore new insight and ideas. For example, our research problem is nowadays children are becoming addicted to electronic gadget. And researcher don't have so much data and information about this problem. That's why researcher decided to explore new information by directly meeting with children. Now we will see some methods of exploratory research. First method is interview method. In interview method, we ask questions to people so that we can get information. Second is focus group. In focus group, a group of people discuss problem. Third is observation. In observation method, we simply observe behavior of people and get information by observing behavior. Last is literature review. In literature review, we collect information from newspaper, books, articles, etc. Second type of research design is descriptive research design. Descriptive research describes situation or case under research study. Descriptive research describe situation or case under research study. And this type of research as it is describe things without doing any alteration. This type of research as it is describe things without doing any alteration. For example, clothing brand wants to get information about current fashion trends so that according to this they can produce. Suppose, according to their research, current market trends are palazzo, denim and baggy. And in their research, they will as it is write, or we can say that they will as it is describe, current fashion trends are palazzo, denim and baggy. Because descriptive research as it is describe things without doing any alteration. Now we will see two methods of descriptive research design. First is case study method. In case study method, we describe particular individual, group or any situation. Second is survey method. In survey method, we collect information from the sample of people by asking them questions. Next, research design is causal research design. Causal research design used to determine cause and effect relation between two separate events. Causal research design used to determine cause and effect relation between two separate events. For example, you do research to see the effect of positive work environment on employees' productivity. And during your research, you found positive work environment is increasing employees' productivity. So here your cause is positive work environment and effect is increase in employees' productivity. So we can say that causal research used to determine cause and effect relation between two separate events. Now we will see one method of causal research design. This method is called experimental method. We do experimental research so that we can establish a causal relationship. We do experimental research so that we can establish a causal relationship. For example, burger store change packaging of burger and observe effect of new packaging on sale of burger. So burger store do this research so that he can see effect of new packaging on sale of burger. Or we can say the burger store do this research so that he can establish causal relationship between new packaging and sale of burger. So this is all about meaning of research design, features of good research design and type of research design. I think you got it, and thank you so much for watching this video. Bye, take care.